Sup bros, today's topic was inspired by a video 555 Gear made in 2018, in which he basically laid out what would be his perfect 3 knife collection if he had to get rid of all of his other knives. So, what if, for some reason, I had to reduce my collection of folding knives down to only 3 knives? Let's get into it. So only 3 knives it is. Obviously, I can only select from the knives I already have, but that's hard enough as it is, so no need to make it more difficult than that. The first knife I would keep, even though I list these in no particular order, would be my Chris Reeve Menandi. This absolutely stunning little knife is the current favorite out of my whole collection. That makes it an easy pick. It has these wonderful polished titanium handles with spalted beech inlays and, like all Chris Reeve's knives, it comes with a blade made out of S35VN steel. There is no getting away from just how elegant and good looking this knife is. I mean, I can see even non-knife people be like, dang bro, that's an awesome knife you got there. The blade stock is quite a bit thinner than on the Sebenza, so it is an awesome slicer. Now, everything I've mentioned so far about this knife is awesome, but what really makes this stand out for me are two factors. First, unlike the Chris Reeve Impinder, this is actually available as a lefty, so I am able to carry it on the side that feels most comfortable for me. Love it. And along the same line, Chris Reeve knives apparently intentionally rounded this nail nick over compared to earlier models of this knife, so that it would be harder to open one-handed. That means that, since this is now a two-handed knife, I can legally carry it here in Germany. So to sum it up, it's a good-looking, awesome, slicey, very well-made knife by one of the most established names in higher-end knife making, and I can legally and comfortably carry it as a lefty. Doesn't get much better than that. The next knife is a bit more complicated. There are too many knives I would like to keep for many different reasons. In the end though, I guess I would still like to have a one-handed knife in my collection, but it has to be one that I would also be able to legally carry where I live. This narrows down the possible options for the second knife to only the Spyderco UK PK and the Hinderer Slippy Slicer. If I had to choose, I would therefore go with the Hinderer Slippy Slicer. With Hinderer knives being another well-established name in the knife world, I'm very glad that they decided to make a slip joint as well, and also include the option to make it a one-handed opening one, but also being able to remove that little tab here if needed. I changed the clip and the filler to get the all-black look with the black G10 scales. The knife overall is well made, the action is smooth, and the finger choil gives you good ergonomics and makes the knife a bit more safe to work with. There's nothing wrong with the UK PK, and it's for sure much better value since it's a fraction of the price of the Hinderer, but because it lacks a liner, it is a lot lighter, which in turn makes it feel a lot cheaper and less sturdy. I don't think it's fragile at all though, it's more of a haptic thing. I just prefer the feel of the Hinderer, so Slippy Slicer it is for me. Not much else to say about that one. Obviously it bums me that the clip can only be set up for right hand carry, but that's just how it is. Aside from that, it is in my opinion the best option, at least that I know of, that allows us peeps here in Germany, or over in the UK, to carry a slip joint knife that can be opened one-handed. Again, it ain't cheap, but good things rarely ever are. I would recommend it if this is something you're interested in. And just a quick note, if those legal restrictions would not exist, this spot would probably be filled with something like the Hinderer XM18, a Spyderco PM3 or a Benchmade 940. Now, for the last knife on this list, it was really a tough call between these three knives, the JE made Lenny's Clip, the GEC Pattern No. 78, and my custom Pioneer X made by Robert J. Lessard. The JE made is probably the best modern slip joint I have ever come across, and the GEC is just such a classic, stylish, timeless and functional item, but the Pioneer X was specifically made to my needs and represents to me the ultimate Swiss Army knife for everyday carry. This really took me some time to figure out, but in the end I went with the Pioneer X. I would sell half of my belongings before ever thinking about getting rid of my GEC 78 or my Lenny's Clip, and I carry both on a regular basis. But the custom Pioneer X Robert J. Lessard made for me is just on another level. I think the models Victorinox sells in their stores are already fantastic, and over the years I've bought a lot of them. But having one made specifically to your needs with titanium handles and a copper cross and a brass frame for the magnification glass, that's just impossible to beat. If you want to see more about this wonderful knife, check out the video I made about it a while ago. And that's my idea of a perfect 3 knife collection, based on the knives I already own. There's no hard user on this list simply because, generally speaking, I tend to use fixed blade knives for harder use tasks. Now I would love to hear what your perfect 3 knife collection would look like. Might be knives you already own, or maybe knives that have forever been on your wishlist. Just leave a comment down below and let me know. Anyway, that's it for me. Thanks for watching and stay safe out there. Bye.